Good morning. Good morning to all. Today's topic is the structure of RNA and its functions, and also the types of RNA. So RNA is one of such nucleic acid. It's also called ribonucleic acid. Apart from DNA, which is a genetic material, RNA is non-genetic material. It is mainly present in the cytoplasm, and less quantity of RNA is present in the nucleus. This RNA is also a polymer of ribonucleotides, which are linked together by 3', 5' phosphodiester linkages. It is a single polynucleotide chain-like structure. It is not comparable to the DNA molecule, which is having two polynucleotide strands, helical structure, but here it is single polynucleotide chain is present, single stranded ribonucleic acid is present. So coming to the variations found in between, these differences found between the RNA and DNA. The RNA is having single stranded nucleic acid, and it is present in the cytoplasm. Most of the RNA are present in the cytoplasm, except the mRNA, which is synthesized in the nucleus by the process called transcription during the protein synthesis. The DNA is double-stranded, helical structure with two polynucleotide chains coiled around each other in a spiral manner. When it is stretched, it looks like a ladder. The two strands, which are the backbones of this DNA molecule, is made up of phosphated sugar, and the nitrogen bases form the steps of ladder. So each nucleotide is binding with the another nucleotide by phosphodiester bond. Just similarly, the same type of phosphodiester bonds are present in between the nucleotides in a single polynucleotide chain. So there are many differences between RNA and DNA. RNA is single-stranded mainly, except when self-complementary sequences are there. It forms a double-stranded structure. So wherever there is a chance of forming false loops, there only they can be converted into, sometimes at some places, it may form a complementary base pairing when they coil, or false loops are formed. But DNA, it appears as it is a double-stranded nucleic acid, except for certain viral proteins, viral DNA, which is a single-stranded, which is very rare cases. Here in the RNA, ribose is the pentose sugar, is the main sugar. In the DNA, that is, it is not ribose, it is deoxyribose is present, which is also a pentose sugar. In RNA, purines and pyrimidines. So in purines, there is adenine and guanine. In pyrimidines, thymine is absent. Instead of thymine, there is uracil. But in DNA, thymine is present. So being a single stranded structure, there is no complementary base pairing in case of RNA. But it is against the Chagoff's rule. It does not follow Chagoff's rule, where the adenine always pairs thymine, guanine always pairs cytosine. And there is a bond between adenine and thymine. There are two hydrogen bonds in guanine and cytosine. There are three hydrogen bonds. But in case of DNA, thymine is present, but uracil is not present. Instead of thymine, in RNA, uracil is present. But in DNA, uracil is absent. Only thymine is present. So it follows Chagoff's rule. So the total purine content in the double-strand DNA is always equal to the it does follow. So it is purine and pyrimidines are equal. Adenine, guanine, thymine and cytosine are present. In between adenine and guanine, two hydrogen bonds are present. In between adenine and thymine, there are two hydrogen bonds. In between guanine and cytosine, there are three hydrogen bonds. So this RNA is easily destroyed by alkalis to cyclic diesters of mononucleotides. but DNA resists alkali action. So by the action of alkalis, the RNA, the polynucleotide chain, there may be separation of nucleotides, but in DNA it is not happening. It is RNA, relatively a liable molecule, that it undergoes easy and spontaneous degradation, whereas DNA is a stable molecule. The spontaneous degradation is very slow. The genetic information can be stored for years together without any change in case of DNA. RNA mainly cytoplasmic, but also present in the nucleus. It is in the form of mRNA, just as I said earlier, during the transcription. From the DNA, genetic information is converted into mRNA in presence of RNA polymerase, which is a first step in the RNA protein synthesis. But DNA is mainly found in the nucleus, in some bacteria-like organisms only. The extra nuclear DNA is found in mitochondria and plasmids, and also in the bacteria-like organisms. Since there is no nucleus, the DNA is present in the cytoplasm. So in RNA, there are various types of RNAs: mRNA, rRNA, tRNA, snRNA, small RNA, miRNA, heterogeneous RNA. These RNAs perform, they have different functions. The DNA is always of one type only. It performs only the function of storage and transfer of genetic information. So this RNA, no variable physiological forms of RNA are found. The different types of RNA do not change their forms. So whatever it may be, the RNA types, the structure remains the same. Single polynucleotide chain is present without any looping or complementary base pairing. But DNA, there is a variable forms of DNA, A to Z, A, B, C, and depending upon the direction of coiling. This RNA is synthesized from the DNA. It cannot form DNA. But from the RNA, RNA is synthesized from DNA, but it cannot form DNA. So this RNA cannot give us to DNA except by the reverse transcriptase, where complementary DNA is formed from the mRNA. This it cannot duplicate except in certain viruses where it is a genomic material. So DNA can form DNA by replication process. So DNA can multiply by replication to form into daughter DNA by semi-conservative method. There are different types of RNA. So in all prokaryotic and eukaryotic organisms, there are three main classes of RNA molecules exist, mainly messenger RNA, transfer RNA, ribosomal RNA. They can be called as mRNA, tRNA, rRNA. They have their specific functions in the cell. The other are smaller nuclear RNA, microRNA, small interfering RNA, and heterogeneous nuclear RNA. But three are very important RNAs. Messenger RNA is also called mRNA. It comprises only 5% of the RNA in the cell. So the total RNA present in the cell, the mRNA is in the, only 5% of RNA is in the form of mRNA. So most heterogeneous in size and base sequence. These all members of the class function as messengers. They carry the information from the DNA of the nucleus to the cytoplasm where the proteins are synthesized. This messenger RNA is formed by the process called transcription by heterocatalytic method. So during this transcription in the nucleus, the double-stranded DNA will be separated temporarily at some places where the genetic one of the polynucleotide chain can act as template DNA. That template DNA is having a nitrogen-based sequence. Depending upon the sequence, the free nucleotides which are present in the nucleus, they will be arranged in the form of a chain. After that, the ligase enzyme binds these two strands to form one DNA strand, another one mRNA strand. Later on, exonucleases, they break the bonds in between these two strands. So again, the mRNA strand is separated and this mRNA moves from the nucleus into the cytoplasm through nuclear pores. After the movement of this mRNA into the cytoplasm, the two separated strands, they will again join by the hydrogen bonds to the influence of enzyme ligase to form the original DNA. The structural characteristic of mRNA has the fifth terminal end is has a cap. This is capped by 7-methylglucosine guanosine triphosphate cap. So methyl guanosine triphosphate cap is present. So this cap is involved in the recognition of mRNA by the translate machinery. It stabilizes mRNA by protecting it from 5' exonucleases. So this cap is present only in the mRNA, not in any other RNAs. It has 7-methyl guanosine triphosphate cap is, at the end there is a polytail with coding and non-coding regions. So depending upon this mRNA, so the 3' end of most of mRNAs have polymer of adenylate residues, that is poly A tail is present. The tail prevents the attack by 3 exonucleases. Histones and interferons do not contain poly A tails. So on both 5 and 3 and there are non-coding sequences, so which are not translated during translation process of protein synthesis. So the nitrogen bases which are present in the mRNA, they form a triplet code. Each triplet code codes for a particular amino acid. So this this code is translated into amino acid sequence where it forms into polypeptide chain or nothing but protein. So this intervening region between non-coding sequences present between 5 and 3 end is called coding region. This region encodes for the synthesis of protein. So this is the structure of mRNA, where at the fifth end there is a cap with the 7-methyl guanosine phosphates, and there is AUG, which is the initiation codon of protein synthesis, and UAG, UGA, UAA are the terminating codons at the end. There is at the third end there is a poly A tail. So in the diagram it shows the 5 cap and 3 tail, which imparts stability to mRNA by protecting from specific exonucleases. There are now coding sequences which have, for the first code is AUG, the last one which stops the translation is either UAA or UAG or UGA. They are called terminating codons. So this mRNA with these triplet codes is very important for the translation during protein synthesis. The mRNA molecules are formed with the help of DNA template during the process of transcription. The sequence of nucleotides in mRNA is complementary to the sequence of nucleotides on template DNA. So just I have earlier mentioned, there is the sequence present on the template DNA is the base for the synthesis of new mRNA strand. This sequence carried on mRNA is read in the form of codons. Each codon is made up of 3 nucleotides, so it is called a triplet code. This mRNA is formed after processing of heterogeneous nuclear RNA. So this heterogeneous RNA is the immediate product of gene transcription. So later on it is processed and there is splicing occurs. The nuclear product is heterogeneous in size and it is very large. The molecular weight may be more than 10^7, while the molecular weight of mRNA is less than 2×10^6. Daltons. That is about 75% of heterogeneous RNA is degraded in the nucleus. Only 25% is processed to become a useful mature mRNA, which is translated during this protein synthesis. This is the conversion of heterogeneous nuclear RNA into a normal mature RNA. So removal of introns, which are non-coding regions, splicing, that is called splicing. So due to the removal of unnecessary codon, which results in the formation of useful mRNA, mature mRNA, which is transported to the cytoplasm, where it is it takes part in the protein synthesis. The very important RNA is the transfer RNA, which is main requisite in the protein synthesis. This transfer RNA are the smallest of three major species of RNA molecules. So this mRNA is having some thousands of nucleotides, but this RNA has below 100 nucleotides. That means they have 74 to 95 nucleotides. So they are synthesized by the nuclear processing of precursor molecules. So they transfer, there are about 20 tRNAs found in the cytoplasm. Each tRNA has it has the specific nature to bind with the specific amino acid, which are activated and present in the cytoplasm during protein synthesis. They transfer the amino acids from the cytoplasm to the protein synthesizing machinery. Hence, the name is called transfer RNA. It is also called soluble RNA and the smallest RNA. They are easily soluble, so it is called soluble RNA or sRNA. They are also called adapter molecules since they act as adapter for the translation of the sequence of nucleotides present on the mRNA into specific amino acid sequence. There are at least 20 species, so about 20 types of amino acids are present in the cytoplasm. For each amino acid, a specific tRNA is present, which carries specific amino acid, charged amino acid, onto the site of protein synthesis. The primary structure of tRNA shows the nucleotide sequence of all the tRNA molecules allows extensive intra-strand complementarity that generates a secondary structure. The secondary structure, each single tRNA shows extensive internal base pairing by looping and acquires a clover leaf like structure. The secondary structure shows the clover leaf as given by Holy and his associates, Holy et al. They gave the structure. The secondary structure of tRNA looks like a clover leaf with false looping and also base pairing and acquires a clover leaf like structure. This structure is stabilized by hydrogen bonding between the bases and it is a consistent feature of this tRNA. The secondary structure of our clover leaf model of tRNA contains five main arms or loops, which are as follows. The acceptor arm, which is also called amino acid site, amino acid site. Just opposite to it is anticodon arm, the dihydroxyridine arm, TCG arm, and extra arm, which does not have any function, unknown function. So one of the acceptor arm is the one to which this acceptor end is attached with the amino acid, particular amino acid. The opposite to this is the anticodon end, which is having a anticodon sequence, which is complementary to the triplet code, which is present on the mRNA and supposed to be translated by this tRNA. So DHU arm, this dihydroxyridine arm is it is recognizing the ribosomes, and TCG arm recognizes the enzyme, which is essential for the translation process. This acceptor arm is at the third end. It has 7 base pairs. The end sequence is unpaired. Cytosine, adenine at the third end. The 3-OH group terminal of adenine binds with the carboxyl group of amino acids, and the binding of amino acid takes place at this end. The tRNA bound with amino acid is called amino acyl tRNA. This amino acyl tRNA is formed in presence of enzyme amino acyl tRNA synthetase. The CC attachment is done after the transcription. So this is the clover leaf structure of tRNA, which shows CCA end, which at which amino particular amino acid is attached. Opposite to this arm is anticodon region with GCC, CGG, which translates GCC codon on the mRNA. So depending upon the anticodon, the codes which are present in the mRNA are translated. So the amino acid which is coding for this GCC is attached to the A site of the tRNA. So by that way, this tRNA, particular tRNA, carries the amino acid to the mRNA based on the complementary sequence of codon and anticodon regions. And also there is an anticodon arm in this. It is opposite to the acceptor end. It has 5 base pairs. It recognizes the triplet codon present in the mRNA. The base sequence of anticodon is complementary to the base sequence of mRNA codon, the triplet code, which should be translated during translation process of protein synthesis. Due to complementarity, it can bind specifically with the mRNA by hydrogen bonds. Dihydroxyridine arm, it has 3 to 4 base pairs. It serves as the recognition site for the enzyme. The amino acid tRNA synthetase enzyme is recognized by this arm that adds the amino acid to the acceptor arm. The TCG arm, if this arm is opposite to dihydroxyridine arm, it contains pseudouridine, that it is why it's so called. It involves the binding of tRNA to the ribosomes. It recognizes our ribosomes. So DHU recognizes the enzyme, amino acid tRNA synthetase. TCG arm recognizes ribosomes. There is extra or variable arm present. About 75% of tRNA molecule possesses a short extra arm. If about 3 to 5 base pairs are present, tRNA is said to be class 1. Majority tRNA belongs to class 1. That means this extra arm is having by false looping or pairing of 3 to 5 base pairs. The tRNA which belongs to class 2 have long extra arm. In this, there are about 13 to 21 base pairs in length. So the tertiary structure of tRNA is L-shaped. So this structure is formed by further folding of the clover leaf due to hydrogen bonding between T and D arms. So the base pair double helical stems get arranged in two double helical columns, continuous and perpendicular to one another. So this is the tertiary structure which is in the form of L shape. There is one more important RNA, that is ribosomal RNA, which is helpful in the which are present in the ribosomes, the composition of ribosomes. So this ribosomal RNA is the main component of ribosomes. The 60S subunit of 80S ribosomes contains 5S rRNA and 5.8S rRNA and 28S rRNA. That means a 60S unit of 80S ribosomes, that is larger unit. 80S ribosome has two units, larger unit 60S, smaller unit 40S. In larger unit, 3 rRNAs are present, and these are probably more than 50 specific polypeptides. There are also probably more than 50 specific polypeptides or proteins are present. That means it is with rRNAs and proteins. Ribosomes are nothing but ribosomal proteins. So they contain rRNAs and proteins. There are about 50 proteins are present, 3 rRNAs are present in 60S unit, that is 5 rRNA and 5.8, 28 rRNAs. The 40S subunit, which is a smaller subunit, is having only 1 rRNA and approximately 30 proteins. All the ribosomal RNA molecules except the 5S rRNA are processed from a single 45S precursor RNA molecule in the nucleolus. So the 5S RNA is independently transcribed. The function of the ribosomal RNA molecule is in the ribosomal particle. They are not fully understood, but they are necessary for ribosomal assemblage and seem to play a key role in the binding of mRNA to ribosomes and during translation process. Recent studies suggest that an rRNA component performs the peptide transferase activity, thus it can be considered as a ribozyme. It is just like an enzyme. There are another type of RNAs. It is most of these molecules, small RNA, which are complex with proteins to form ribonucleoproteins and are distributed in the nucleus. The cytoplasm are in both. They range in size from 20 to 30 nucleotides and are present in many copies. Along with this one, there are small nuclear RNAs are present, snRNAs. This snRNA is a subset of small RNAs which are significantly involved in mRNA processing and gene regulation. Of the several small nuclear RNAs, U1, U2, U4, U5, and U6 are involved in intron removal, that is non-coding region, removal of non-coding regions and the processing of heterogeneous RNA into matured RNA, which is translated during protein synthesis. The U7 small nuclear RNA is involved in the production of the correct 3 ends of histone mRNA, which lacks a poly A tail. This is a small nuclear RNA. So exons are coding regions, introns are non-coding regions. They can be spliced and separated from this, and the coding regions are joined together to form into mature mRNA. So this from heterogeneous with the introns or non-coding regions, it converted into the matured mRNA, which is having completely coding region. This snRNA are involved in the processing of splicing, the removal of introns of primary transcript to form mature mRNA. The small nuclear RNAs form complexes with the proteins to form ribonucleoprotein particles called snRNPs. So the DNA, which is a single polynucleated chain, single stranded nucleic acid. So these nucleic acid is having many nucleotides in a straight chain. There, nucleotides are binding one another with phosphodiester bonds. In each nucleotide, there is phosphate molecule, pentose or ribose sugar, nitrogen bases. These nitrogen bases are purines and pyrimidines. In RNAs, purines are adenine and guanine. Pyrimidines are uracil and cytosine. Here in this RNAs, thymine is absent. In place of thymine, uracil is present. There is no complementary base pairing. Sometimes these single-stranded polynucleotide RNA may be folded on itself to form false loops. There only there is temporary base pairing can be seen. So there are different types of RNAs, mRNA, rRNA, and tRNA. This mRNA is having thousands of nucleotides, rRNA, hundreds of nucleotides, but tRNA, which is very small, it has just below 100 nucleotides are present, which is the smallest one. The mRNA codes the genetic information from DNA into mRNA. It carries the information from the nucleus into the cytoplasm, where the genetic information is used to carry out the protein synthesis. This RNA, being a part of ribosome structure, helps in the protein formation of protein operators. This tRNA is very important, which carries, which transfers a specific amino acid, which is charged in the cytoplasm. And this charged amino acid is taken up by the tRNA, and this tRNA transfers onto the site of mRNA, where it translates the triplet codons present on the mRNA during the translation process, finally to form into a polypeptide chain or protein. So this is about the very important nucleic acid called ribonucleic acid. It is present mostly in the cytoplasm. It is not genetic material, but in viruses, it may be in some implant viruses, it is a genetic material. Then only it acts as a genetic material. Otherwise, it is non-genetic material. Simply, it helps in the protein synthesis only.